To open our program, please welcome from the cross country and track teams, sophomore Christine Walsh and junior Emily Isidorzak.
It's been a huge year for Bonnie Sports and our student athletes. We are here to celebrate the amazing athletic and academic accomplishments. Tonight, we want you to reflect on all the hard work you've put in, but want you to have a good time. If you are one of the award recipients tonight, please come down the stairs and enter on this side, receive your award, and then exit here and get your photo taken in the media backdrop. SAC is a committee made up of student athletes on all Division I teams and serves as the voice on university committees representing St. Bonaventure athletes in the Atlantic 10. The SAC members provide insight on issues that impact athletes and to offer input on the rules, regulations, and policies that affect student athletes' lives on our campus and on other campuses. SAC on campus builds a positive atmosphere with all athletics, generates a student-athlete voice to perform policies, and promotes communication between athletes and athletics administration.
So this fall, I went to two conferences through SAC, and the first one was the NCAA Leadership Forum. This forum was an amazing experience for me and 5,000 student-athletes. I have grown personally and professionally, gained a new network of friends and peers, as well as experienced the rewards of community service. I have found more about myself and the type of leader that I am. I encourage every student athlete in this audience to take every opportunity that you have because it may lead to life-changing experiences. I also went to the D1 SAC Joint A10 Conference and I learned so much from other A10 schools. We voted on legislation such as when recruits should be allowed to come to campus. I also learned about the SACs on other campuses and we are currently trying to implement their aspects into our program as well. These two experiences allowed me to grow as an individual and as an athlete, and I am thankful for the opportunity. Thank you.
And now, please direct your attention to the video board for our year in review.
Them running.
sponsor of the Bonnie's Choice Awards is the United States Marine Corps. Now please welcome from the Marine Corps, Captain Alex Kurian and Staff Sergeant Andrea Shapiro.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Captain Alex Kurian of the United States Marine Corps.
And I'm Staff Sergeant Shapiro.
And on behalf of the Marine Corps, I thank you for having us here tonight. Since 10 November 1775, the Marine Corps has been dedicated in service to community, our country, and the world. The mission of the Marine Corps is to make Marines, win our nation's battles, and develop quality citizens. We do these three things by following our core values: honor, courage, and commitment. Honor serves as the bedrock of our character as United States Marines. Honor is found in serving our country, the strength of our will, and never leaving a Marine behind. It is what takes, as you were, it is what keeps Marines professional, strong, and willing to do what needs to be done. Commitment is the spirit of determination and dedication, the will to do what is right and to see it through. If honor is our foundation and commitment is our will, courage is the heart of our core values. Courage is more than the ability to overcome fear. Courage comes in many forms, physical, mental, and moral. Courage is the strength to stand up and fight for what's right, the will to strive for more, and the ability to survive and overcome all that life throws at us. The United States Marine Corps Courage Award was earned by student athletes who have embodied this type of courage on and off the field. The female finalists for the United States Marine Corps Courage Award are Haley Gattaso from the cross country team, Serafina Martin from the soccer team, and McKenna Maycock from the basketball team. And the winner is Serafina Martin. The male finalists for the United States Marine Corps Courage Award are Zach Murphy from the swim team, Jake Oswald from the cross country team, and Courtney Stockard from the basketball team. And the winner is Courtney Stockard.
And now, please welcome, from the women's lacrosse team, Molly Driscoll and Kira O'Gorman.
To kick off the show, the first award that we're going to present is Rookie of the Year. The Rookie of the Year Award honors the best athletic performance from a first year or a transfer student. The finalists for the Male Rookie of the Year are Nicole Abonzo from soccer, Danny Giaganis from the golf team, and TJ Koosh from the swim team. And the winner is TJ Koosh.
The finalists for Female Rookie of the Year are Emily Calabrese from basketball, Samantha Henry from cross country and track, and Lena Cusco from the swim team. And the winner is Lena Cusco from women's swimming. The next award for this evening is the Rising Star Award. This award celebrates a sophomore or junior student athlete that has high hopes for future athletic success. The female finalists for Rising Star Award are Sydney Beeman from cross country and track, Riley Hare from softball, and Sabrina Sousa Sampson from soccer. And the winner is, it's a tie. The winners are Sydney Beeman from the women's cross country team and Riley Hare from softball.
And now, here are the finalists for the Male Rising Star Award. Amadi Akpizi from basketball.
Yeah, fuck.
Mike McNanty from baseball. Indra Pat Warden from tennis. And David Shek Nazaroff from swimming. And the winner is Mike McNanty.
For being a small school, we are fortunate to have international students as our peers, our teammates, and our friends. Our international students add so much to our teams and to our campus. To show our appreciation of the dedication and sacrifices you make being away from home, we put together this slideshow for you.
And now, please welcome from the softball team, Brooke Kane Walker and Allie Pierre Gustavo.
The next award we have tonight celebrates our breakthrough performers. These athletes improved their performance dramatically and have raised the bar. These athletes were nominated as our most improved student athletes.
The finalists for the male breakthrough performer are Ben Contento from the baseball team, Ladarian Griffin from the basketball team, and Jordan Powers from the swim team. And the Bonnie goes to Ladarian Griffin from the basketball team.
The finalists this evening for Female Breakthrough Performer are Riley Arnold from the lacrosse team, Allie Deal from the softball team, Danielle McGlory from the basketball team, and Christine Walsh from the cross country and track team. And the Bonnie goes to Riley Arnold from the lacrosse team.
And now, please welcome McKenna Maycock from the women's basketball team and Matt Abendroff from the golf team.
This next award is for the person that is the heart of the team. They may not play the most minutes on the team, they may not score the most points, runs, or goals, but they do show up every day and they go hard. They are a central component to the team. By their hard work and dedication, they make each of us better. These finalists were nominated by their coaches instead of their teammates. We asked coaches for their suggestions about who are the behind the scenes hero of their sport.
The nominees for the Male Unsung Hero Award are Paul Affle from soccer, Matt Bacher from cross country and track, Corey Long from golf, and Aiden Wilson from swimming. And the winner is, we have a tie. The winners are Matt Bacher from men's cross country and track and Aiden Wilson from men's swimming.
Thank you.
All right, so the female nominees for the Unsung Hero Award are Kerrigan Cummins from lacrosse, Rachel Geyer from cross country and track, Serafina Martin from soccer, and Emily Wolf from swimming. And the winner is Rachel Geyer from women's cross country.
Before we get into these last three awards, we just want to say thank you to everyone involved in making this show happen tonight. Without your help and support, none of this would be possible. So thank you to all the coaches, assistants, managers, athletic training staff, strength and conditioning team, ticket office, Raina's hardworking staff, department interns, grad assistants, academic support staff, and athletic administration. To all of you, thank you very much.
Next, we have the Riley Award. This award represents student athlete that represents what it means to be a Bonnie. There's a lot more to being a Bonnie than just playing your sport and attending school. A Bonnie excels in the classroom, a Bonnie dominates in their sport, and a Bonnie is a positive presence in the community. The nominees are all hardworking, honest, and caring individuals. They abide by the Franciscan values that our school is built on, and they are the leaders on campus. The male finalists for the Riley Award are Alex Schutz from baseball, Dries Takei from basketball, and Aiden Wilson from swimming. All right, and the winner is Alex Schutz from baseball.
The female finalists for the Riley Award are Gabriella Bowe from tennis, Erin Carmody from swimming, and Sydney Cassignall from soccer.
And the winner is Sydney Castagnol for women's soccer.
And now for the final two Bonnie's Choice Awards of the night, please welcome from the softball team, Morgan Phillips, and Jack Petruka from the swim team.
The plays of the year were nominated by student athletes. Instead of student athletes voting, we opened the voting to these plays to all of Bonnie Nation. The Sports Information and Communications Office put these highlights on Twitter and let all of our fans vote for the winners. The nominees for the men's play of the year are Kieran Toland with his amazing goal. The second is Matt Mobley's buzzer beater. And the third is Courtney Stockard's game-winning basket. And the winner is Kieran Toland.
Good job, Jack.
Kieran is not present tonight because he is training with a major league team. We wish him the best of luck.
Nominees for the Women's Play of the Year are, the first highlight is Mariah Marrero's game-winning goal. The second highlight is of our women's swim team's gold medal 400 medley relay. And the third highlight is from our women's basketball team with Mariah Ross buzzer beater. And the winner is Women's Swim 400 Medley Relay, Devin McFadden, Lena Kutsko, Mariah Rocky, and Katrina Wardner.
Our final award of the night is the Athlete of the Year Award. This award is given to the male and female student athlete that you have voted who have had the best athletic performance and have had significant impacts on their team.
The finalists for the Female Athlete of the Year Award are Emily Isadorzak from cross country, Devin McFadden from the swimming and diving team, and Mariah Ruff from the basketball team. And the winner is Mariah Ruff from women's basketball.
The finalists for the Male Athlete of the Year Award are Jalen Adams from the basketball team, Tiard Krush from the swim team, and Kieran Tolan from the soccer team. No music. And the winner is Jalen Adams from men's basketball.
Before we continue with the rest of the program, we want to have a special presentation. We'd like to welcome back Emily Isadorzak and also welcome Keely Fresh.
Everyone, so we have one more award before the department awards. This final award is not found in the program, as we wanted to surprise the individual receiving this award tonight. This individual has done so much for student athletes, from organizing the production of a movie to send out to the A10, to selling bobbleheads for our SAC fundraiser, and to writing the script for this award show, all on top of mentoring students, which is her original job. This individual is an asset to all student athletes at St. Bonaventure, and her hard work does not go unnoticed. This year, we decided that our first ever faculty award goes to Heather McDivitt.
And I thank you all very much. I was told to announce I'm not going to be back in this role next year, so I want to thank you all very, very much. I'm still going to be at St. Bonaventure. You can still find me, but I'm going to be teaching. So So I just want to thank all the students and coaches and support staff for making these 5 years wonderful, and I look forward to remaining a Bonnie and seeing many of you in the classroom. So thank you.
All right, carrying on with the rest of the program, the senior awards. My name is Steve Mest. I'm Associate Athletic Director here and also a proud Bonnie's graduate. I'm proud to serve as your MC the rest of the way. I want to thank everyone involved with the Student Athlete Advisory Committee. Fantastic job on tonight's Bonnie's Choice Awards and all year long. Give yourselves a round of applause, please. Great job. Some quick housekeeping before we get started. All the pictures from tonight will be available on GoBonnies.com starting tomorrow, so you can look them up there. So please don't bug Scott Eddie, we'll drive him crazy. Also, I want to thank Mike White. He's our DJ tonight over here. Good job, Michael. See, the deal is, if you win the Athlete of the Year the previous year, then you have to become the DJ the next year. So Jay Adams, you're on deck. We'd like to recognize first our top performing teams in the classroom. You all are a remarkable group of student athletes. You challenge each other in many ways, including a friendly competition for academic success amongst our teams. However, as in any competition, there are winners. When I announce the winning teams with the top GPAs, please stand so we can be recognized. The top grade point average amongst all of our women's teams with a GPA of 3.48 is the softball team. Ladies. And the top GPA out of all the men's teams, with a GPA of 3.53, is the golf team. Congratulations to both teams. The second portion of that is, of course, that you student athletes achieve high marks individually. We have plenty of you here tonight. We would now like to recognize all of the 94 student athletes who hold a career GPA of 3.5 or higher, thus qualifying for our Athletic Director's Honor Roll. We've listed all of you in the program tonight. At this time, please stand so you can properly be acknowledged. Please. The list is in the program. Check it out. Well done. Keep up the great work. And now I'd like to introduce Deputy Athletics Director Barb Cuesta for a special presentation. Barb.
Thank you, Steve. The 11-10 Conference awards 14 postgraduate scholarships, valued at $5,000 each, to a graduating senior from each member institution. as administrators, we are charged with a very difficult task of deciding who should be St. Bonaventure's recipient. And when I use the word difficult, it's extremely difficult, as we have some of the best and brightest students not only here at St. Bonaventure who are athletes, but also in the entire Atlantic 10. However, it gives me great pleasure to announce this year's winner. A biochemistry major, this individual carries a 3.833 cumulative GPA and has been named to both the Dean's List and the A-10 Commissioner's Honor Roll numerous times, as well as being named Atlantic 10 Academic All-Conference in 2017 and 2018. He co-founded SBU's chapter, the American Society for Biochemistry and Molecular Biology, and received two grants as an undergraduate, including one from the American Society for Plant Biologists to help defray travel costs associated with research presentations. Over the past two summers, he has presented or has had his work presented for him at various research conferences, including in Athens, Georgia, Honolulu, Hawaii, Cleveland, Ohio, and Austin, Texas. His impressive research resume contains words that I cannot even begin to understand nor pronounce correctly. He has mentored high school students in a research lab and volunteered his time at both the Warming House and the SPCA. And he accomplished all this while being a three-year member of the men's swimming and diving program. He has been accepted into Duke University's graduate school, where he plans on becoming a college professor. This educational path will provide him the opportunity to pursue his passion for research while helping generations to come. A native of Lakewood, New York, a St. Bonaventure 2018 Atlantic 10 Conference Postgraduate Scholarship is awarded to Jordan Powers.
A tradition that is part of the senior award ceremony is a chance to thank and salute our graduating student athletes, the class of 2018. Each of you committed to St. Bonaventure University, wore the brown and white proudly, and now have reached the pinnacle, graduation, in just a week's time. As a small token of our appreciation, the athletics department will now present every senior a Bona portfolio and a sash to wear at commencement that identifies you as a student athlete. All of our seniors are listed in tonight's program. At this time, we ask that you all come down to the court, line up over on this side, and in alphabetical order, we're gonna recognize each one of our seniors. We're gonna start with the baseball team. If you'd all come forward with your head coaches or representative assistant coaches right now, please come on down. All right, here's how we're going to do this. I'm going to introduce each senior individually from the team, bring them up to the stage. Why don't we hold our applause, and then we'll applaud for each team after we go through them. So here to present for the baseball coaching staff, TJ Baker and assistant coach BJ Salerno. First senior from baseball, Matt Eastman. Nate Grant. Ryan McCarrick. Ryan O'Connor. Brandon Schlimm. Dave Vaccaro. And Roman Wild. Senior class from the baseball team. All right, for men's basketball, here's head coach Mark Schmidt and senior Idris Taki. Matt Mobley could not be with us tonight. He's training in Las Vegas. For the men's cross country and track team, head coach Bob McFarlane and his seniors, Matt Bacher, Ethan Kibbe, and Levi Malone. All right, for the golf team, we have assistant coach Josh Stauffer. And the team's two seniors, Corey Long and Pat Shearer. All right, for men's soccer, head coach is Kwame Aduro, and his seniors, Paul Afool, Kyle Kleckner, Peter Rutsis, and Kieran Toland. All right, men's swimming and diving. Head coach Sean McNamee. Yeah. Seniors Ben Galinsky, yeah. Logan Helwig, yeah. Trevor Maeda, yeah. Jordan Powers, yeah. Matt Tackard, yeah. And Aiden Wilson. And men's tennis, head coach Mike Bates and his two seniors, Victor Blanco and Hector Martinez. All right, for the women's basketball team, and head coach Jesse Fleming, and his seniors Keely Fresh and Mariah Ruff. Women's cross country and track, head coach Bob McFarlane, Nicolette Demira, Haley Gattuso, Megan Jennings, and Rachel Martin. Women's lacrosse, head coach Chelsea Rosick, and her seniors, Gabrielle Bradley, Morgan Conroy, Kerrigan Cummins, Emily Foster, and Christine Wallace. Softball, head coach Mike Threehouse, Haley Blenko, Josie Borsevich, and Morgan Phillips. Women's soccer, head coach Steve Bradarski, and his seniors, Sydney Casignol, Beth Moore, Alex Pochop, Brittany Tubiolo, and Danielle Viss. Women's swimming and diving, head coach Brian Thomas, and his five seniors, starting with Alyssa Lavak, Devin McFadden, Maria Rocky, Michaela Ryan, and Emily Wolf. Last but certainly not least, the women's tennis team, and again, head coach Mike Bates and his four seniors, Gabrielle Bowe, Francesca Chin, Eleanor Gerhard, and Dominique Mortier. Hey, how about one final round of applause for the class of 2018, our seniors. It's now time for our athletic department annual senior awards. These awards were founded back in the 1970s, so there is a tradition and a legacy from past winners. Selecting the winners is always a very difficult job, and this year was no exception. The nominees were submitted by coaches and staff and chosen by our athletics administrative team. Tim Kenny and Barb Cuesta will present the awards. First is the Brian Moretti Service Award. This is presented annually to a graduating senior for outstanding service, dedication, and commitment to the Department of Athletics. It may go to either a student athlete or a non-athlete. In 2014, this award was dedicated to the memory of Assistant Sports Information Director Brian Moretti, who passed away unexpectedly March 5th of that year. Brian was only here for a short time, but he left an unforgettable impression through his tireless work ethic, his dedication, and love of his craft, in particular the work he did with the women's basketball program. It was a privilege to know Brian and his family, and we are thrilled to present this award in his name again tonight. This year's recipient has quite literally grown up in our department. Many of the coaches and staff here have known him since he was very young, hanging around the RC with his family. Since enrolling as a freshman, he's been involved in the department in many roles. He has been an intern in the communications office for 3 years, working one time or another at every home event, as well as in our office. He's also worked behind the scenes at every home basketball game, including the last 2 years in the video control room. After spending a year as a walk-on the soccer team, he transitioned to the team's manager, helping the coaching staff as they have rebuilt the program into an A-10 postseason club. He will graduate with a degree in strategic communications and pursue a master's degree here starting next fall. Please join me in congratulating this year's Brian Moretti Award winner, Matt Federko. The Ray D. Leadership Award is named for the 1964 Bonas graduate who was a past chair of the university's Board of Trustees as well as a loyal donor to our athletic programs. The award is presented to the senior who, through his or her leadership skills, sets a positive example for others to follow and builds pride for St. Bonaventure Athletics. The person will have maintained the highest standards of performance, integrity, sportsmanship, and respect. This year, we're pleased to have co-winners. Our first winner was a 4-year starter for the women's soccer team and a 2-year team captain. Her leadership qualities were evident from her freshman season when she was named to the Atlantic 10's all-rookie team. She went on to become one of the top players in the conference every year after, starting all 4 years. Her coach, Steve Brodarski, summed up her attitude this way. She does not believe in being selfish. She does not understand personal glory, and she lives for the success of her team and her teammates. She's been equally impressive in her studies, maintaining better than a 3.6 GPA as an accounting major. The first co-winner of the Ray D. Leadership Award is Danielle Viss. Thank you. Our second winner was a three-year co-captain of the men's basketball team, something that's virtually unheard of. His determination, selfless attitude, and competitive will drove his team to two postseason berths, including this year's record-setting NCAA season. A player with no ego, he did all the little things necessary for his team to win. Defend, rebound, screen, sacrifice. Over his career, the team won 87 games, a record for a graduating class. He will be remembered first and foremost as a winner and a leader. The second co-winner of the Ray D. Leadership Award is Idris Taqi. The Merit Award is presented every year to one senior male and one senior female student athlete for outstanding academic achievement, significant athletic achievement, and meaningful contribution to the St. Bonaventure community. First, the Women's Merit Award. We are again happy to have selected co-winners. Our first winner was a three-year starter for the soccer team. She was a team captain who battled back from a knee injury that forced her to miss the entire 2015 season. Returning to play 13 games last season and then all 19 this year. Over her career, she played 49 games, all on defense. She has made the Dean's List, the A-10 Commissioner's Honor Roll, and the Academic All-District Team, holding over a 3.9 GPA as a double major in finance and accounting. She's a Pacioli Scholar, the Equity Fund Manager for SIM, and a member of the Business Honor Society, as well as a volunteer for numerous team and university charitable efforts. The first co-winner of the Women's Merit Award is Sydney Casagnol. Our second winner also persevered through rehab from a major knee injury in the middle of her Bonas career. A defender for the lacrosse team, she started 35 games over her career, playing in 54 altogether. This season, she started 17 games and scored a career-high 6 goals with 2 assists and 29 ground balls. A management major, she has a 3.96 GPA and has made the Dean's List and A-10 Commissioner's Honor Roll every semester of her college career. She made the A-10 Women's Lacrosse Academic All-Conference team last year and is a member of the Business Honor Society as well as Phi Eta Sigma. She's also been active in community service at both the Warming House and Olean Food Pantry. The second co-winner of the Women's Merit Award is Christine Wallace. And now the Men's Merit Award. Our recipient has been a top contributor on the swim team for 3 years after transferring here to Bonas. He was a valued relay swimmer, regularly filling in wherever the team needed him. This season, he earned all conference honors on the 200 freestyle relay. A biochemistry major, With better than a 3.8 GPA, he also earned academic all-conference honors. Next year, he will begin graduate school at Duke, studying genetics. And as you heard earlier tonight, he's our winner of the A10 Post-Grad Scholarship. This year's Men's Merit Award goes to Jordan Powers. The Letter Winner Award is presented every year to one senior male and one senior female student athlete who have assembled outstanding records of athletic accomplishment over their careers and have proven instrumental to their team's success. This year, we are happy to have co-winners of the Women's Letter Winner Award. Our first recipient was the top swimmer for the Bonnies the past two seasons, setting school records in her backstroke and medley events 2 years in a row. This year, she set a total of 7 school records and scored almost 80 points at the A-10 championship meet. Her A-10 meet included a first place win as part of the 400 medley relay, bronze medals in the 200 backstroke, 200 individual medley, and on the 400 free relay. Her time in the 200 back was an NCAA B-cut qualifier. Beyond times and points, her leadership and sacrifice helped drive the program to huge improvements, topped by a fifth place showing at the A-10s this year. A sociology major, she is also a Dean's List student and an academic all-conference selection. The first co-winner of the Women's Letter Winner Award is Devin McFadden. Our second recipient has been a leader on the women's basketball team for 4 years. She began her career as an impact freshman and improved as a sophomore to become a key player on the Bonnies NCAA tournament team that beat Oklahoma State in the first round. The past two seasons, she continued to increase her scoring and assist totals, etching her name all over the school record books. She is one of only 4 players in program history with over 1,000 points and 400 assists. She ranks 4th in team history in assists, 5th in three-pointers, 12th in scoring, and 10th in double-figure scoring games. This season, she was named to the All-Conference second team as well as the academic All-Conference team. Our second co-winner of the Women's Letter Winner Award is Mariah Ruff. The Men's Letter Winner Award recipient caught Bonnies fans by surprise his freshman year when he opened the season as the starter at point guard for a very strong team. And he never really looked back at all from day one, as he proved he belonged with the A-10's best his sophomore season when he was named to the first team All-Conference and helped the Bonnies to 22 wins and an NIT berth. Last season, he repeated on the All-Conference first team after being the only Division I player to rank in the top 25 in both scoring and assists. Entering this year, he was named to the watch list for the Wooden Award, Naismith Trophy, and the Oscar Robertson Award given to the National Player of the Year. He delivered in the most important way, and that is team success, as he helped lead St. Bonaventure to the NCAA tournament in a school record 26 wins. He was named the A-10's Cult Player of the Year and an honorable mention All-American. The winner of this year's Men's Letter Winner Award is Jalen Adams. And now to close our program, please welcome Director of Athletics, Tim Kenny.
I'll try and make this quick. I remember, who was on the SAC 2-3 years ago? Any of the SAC members? Was anyone on it then? Right? And we sat around and we talked about this evening and what we wanted to do and what the difference, different things. I couldn't be more proud of you as a group who put this on. It gets better and better each year. And really, it's a celebration of you. And there's a lot of work that goes into it. So on behalf of me, the entire staff and the university, I'd like to give a round of applause to all the SAC members who made this happen. I'd also like to thank this year the Marines. With your support, you've helped us make this a great evening, and we thank you for everything you do for us and for the country. And thank you very much for joining us today. It was great to have you here. There's a couple of folks I want to recognize before we go that helped put this on from the back of the house. Okay? First and foremost, our facility staff. Where's Ray? I see you over there. Folks, Ray, Cheryl, and Matt Mason get everything ready for you guys to compete. So often they do it without any, with unheralded, they just go. And they're a great group and they get this stuff going. So thank you very much, Ray, Matt, and Cheryl. I don't see the other two, but thank you very much for helping, for setting this whole thing up tonight. Heather McDivitt and Scott Eddy. Where's Scott? For their organization, the whole event, and once again, Heather kind of let it out the bag. Heather, we're going to miss you. You know how much we love you and how much this group of kids loves you. We're glad you're still going to be here, but we know you're taking your passion and doing what you really want to do is teach classes. So just make sure you let them miss class for competition, please. Asa Johnson, Dylan Nuzzo. Asa's in the back running the video, but all the video and everything you see up there, those two guys put this all together, and throughout the year, they're out there trying to get you guys on film, really promote everything you're doing, so thank you guys. Last but not least, Nicole Boyette, Jess Stender, for all the decorations, setting everything up, and you could all thank them for Nicole for getting the ice cream that you'll be having afterwards. She was able to do that, so thank you so much, guys. On nights like this, I'm reminded of a quote. For those of you who don't know, I was a swimmer in college. And yeah, well, it explains a lot. You're not supposed to spend that much time in chlorine. You'll realize that. Your seniors, I saw all of you coming up. I'm like, you don't have to jump in the pool again. It's a wonderful thing. But my coach said to me when I was a freshman, when I got on the campus, he said, winners are not people who never fail, but people who never quit. When I look out here right now, that's what you guys are. I see winners. Nobody quits. No matter what, no matter whether it is, it's weather, school, hard times, you don't quit. And that's something you need to keep with you moving forward. To all the seniors, take that attitude. Go with it. Live your dreams. Trust me, a lot of people look at student athletes because of that. And they want to hire you. They want to bring you onto their businesses, their corporations, schools, because of that attitude. All right? Remember that. Take it with you. You learned a lot with that. We thank you for everything you've done. We're going to miss you. But know this. The saying, as it always goes, right? Where's scarf? He puts it on the scarf. Right, coach? Once a Bonnie, always a Bonnie. So, seniors, once again, let's give a round of applause for them. And we're going to miss you. And for the rest of you, we still got you. You're still here. Keep on grinding and learning every day. This experience will be the most valuable of your lives, no matter what you may, no matter how hard it is at times. You have to know this. What you learn and what you get through here is what you're going to take with the rest of your life. So just remember that going forward, and we congratulate all of you for your accomplishments. Once again, I want to say congratulations to everybody. I want to thank the coaches, the staff, everybody here. This is a celebration of all of you. We're here for you. We're here to help you out. All right, so thank you so much for everything you do for St. Bonaventure, and we hope you have a great night. Now you can go get that ice cream Nicole said, right out here by the fast break room. So thank you and have a great evening.
Jordan, Applebee's.
Oh, they got Dollar Mart. That's exactly.